CATEX TV. My name is Frank Torcinato. Today is Tuesday, January 29th, 2013. There was a passenger plane down in Kazakhstan. Apparently, it was carrying a group of about 20 passengers and crew. It crashed near the Kazakhstan capital, Almaty. 15 passengers and 5 crew members were on board. The airline was named SCAT Airlines, S-C-A-T. SCAT, according to the website, operates Boeing 757 to 737s, along with Yak 42s and the AN-24. This spoke with AN-24, which has had a number of incidents over the past several years. Meanwhile, here in England, a British Air 747 jumbo jet, yesterday, which departed George Bush Intercontinental Airport in Houston, was forced to make an emergency landing in Wales at Cardiff Airport after a mayday alert was issued by the pilot. The landing site was about 90 miles west of its eventual destination, London Heathrow, was flight number 196 and 138 passengers on board. Cardiff is a relatively small town, however, it has a very long runway. It's a runway at times used by the Concorde. Entirely precautionary landing, apparently, the plane that moved on to Heathrow later in the afternoon. In Africa today, French President Hollande is saying that France is winning the battle against the Mali rebels. They've taken over the city of Timbuktu, the sub-Saharan trading capital. Apparently, there was an outbreak of rampage that destroyed the priceless cultural heritage. And the departing rebels set fire to buildings holding tens of thousands of manuscripts of the ancient Muslim world and from ancient Greece, which was set aflame. Between 60,000 and 100,000 documents and manuscripts have been destroyed. If this is true, this is a priceless destruction of a very interesting text. Airline safety inspectors have apparently found no fault with the batteries used by the Boeing 787 Dreamliner. All 50 Dreamliners, of course, except for Ethiopia Air, have been grounded across the world as a result of a series of safety incidents, including an emergency landing in Japan. It's been thought that the plane batteries were the main cause of the problem, but now they've been given the all clear. So actually, this is going to raise further concerns that there's not going to be a quick fix. Attention has now moved to the electrical system, the monitoring system, as we reported yesterday, that keeps track of battery voltage, charges, and temperature. Well, this isn't good news. There have been a number of outbreaks on the anniversary of the Egyptian uprising over Colonel Hosni Mubarak. 65 people have been killed in an arrest that started last Thursday, and the Egyptian Army Chief of Staff has warned of the collapse of the state if the political crisis blowing the nation for the past week or so continues. Warned by Abdel Fattah al-Sisi, came as the country sinks deeper into violence. What is interesting is how the Chief of Staff of the Army made the announcement. He put it on the Army's official Facebook page. For the second time in as many weeks, extremely high pollution levels have shrouded the Chinese capital of Beijing, forcing cancellation of flights because of poor visibility and prompting government warnings to keep residents indoors. The outlines of the buildings in the capital receded into a thick white mist as pedestrians put on face masks against the thick caustic air. The U.S. Embassy reported a peak level of PM parts per million 2.5, one of the worst pollutants level ever, with 526 micrograms per cubic meter over on the index, and 20 times higher than the World Health Organization safety levels over a 24-hour period. Worse, Chinese Lunar New Year is about to begin, which is the highest travel time in China. Flights are being canceled. It's not a good move. That's the news for today. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.